Oh my god. Oh my god.
Oh no. Oh crap. That's bad. That's bad.
That is so not cool.
Uh-oh. Stinky.
Are you there? Are you there? Hi, Mom.
Hello, everyone. My hair looks so horrible, doesn't it?
I loved your hair. She was always so attractive and good at math. She was a math whiz. She was so intelligent.
I love math. I'm good with numbers. Maybe you should put on some makeup.
I am wearing makeup, Mom. Your skin is so soft.
I love the story of how Dad proposed to you.
Yes. We were ice skating. He was such a beautiful skater. How could I say no?
I love to hear you sing.
I miss singing those alto parts with Vivian Francis.
She typed really fast.
She collected dolls from around the world.
She loved shopping.
She liked to exercise. Looking at photographs. She liked going to the beach and watching the waves.
She liked sitting by the fire. She likes snow days,
ice cream,
animals.
Chocolate.
She loved jigsaw
coffee, puzzles.
Christmas. Apricot sours. She loved to dance.
Well, I miss dancing.
I miss our family dinners together.
It wasn't easy cooking for four generations of family members every
day. She liked to hear me play the piano. She loves her grandchildren.
What was that spice you added to your vegetarian chili?
You'll have to figure it out for
She
yourself.
Loved dressing up to go out.
Parties.
She liked watching others ride the merry-go-round.
Family get-togethers.
She liked riding her bicycle.
Remember the
she
time
we'd
go Christmas shopping at Peddler's Village?
Oh, those apple dumplings.
Can you believe Donald Trump is president?
Bullshit.
She loved walking in the rain.
I remember your lead foot, Mom.
What did you do when you turned 21?
She drank strawberry daiquiris at a nightclub in New York City in 1942. Big band music was my favorite. It's still my favorite. I'll be back.
So long. Smile for the camera.
Cheese.
My name's Drew. It's spelled D-R-E-W. I'm a fourth year senior. My major is technically art, new media, with a film minor or film concentration, I think, but I always get it all confused. Film, like being the sort of cultural staple that it is, it like influenced me, but then more specifically, as I was coming up and I was experimenting with film as like a young person, in middle school I had a foreign language teacher, he was my German teacher, and the whole class was designed around learning the structure of the language, but implementing it in storytelling. So all the tests, all the projects, all the quizzes were some sort of like media presentation.
Yeah, super classy. One prima do.
I've always been nerdy about lots of different things. Like I've always been interested in how things work or whatever. I've always really loved science and math when I was younger. But I also loved like literature. I loved storytelling. I loved reading books. So I think like in terms of what my interests were when I was a young person, it feels like the natural progression of things where it's like sort of the meeting of this sort of like tech world and all of the ins and outs of these machines essentially you use to do something, but also marrying that with literature and storytelling a little bit. I think it is just about like communicating ideas that maybe you feel like you can't get out that well with words.
Guess who's back? Oh, no.
Shift here. It's not too hard to track him down.
I got you something.
Hey, what's that?
No way.
Let's go inside.
Thank you.
Should I wait outside?
No.
How long do we wait for these things to take?
Can I smoke in here?
I mean, no.
Sorry.
How long has it
been? A minute, maybe a minute and a half.
Well, I gotta start prepping, so.
You can wait another minute.
Do you really think you could be a mother?
It's what humans were made to do, right?
Can we just check it already? Thank you. So what are you gonna do?
Look, man, it's gonna be all right. You're gonna have a great time. It'll be fun. Come on.
Come on, dude, hurry up. Let's go.
Thank you. about your sins at all. When you come out, you sins at all. Don't catch a jet back to that land. Uber rich, you're an intern. A wiki bitch. A post-op that form goes highly. In the mountain, I'm going to be ready for you. Back changer, we put to aggressive. Yin and yang, and you know it is. I'm a boy, you're a tech hacker.
Go over the opening phrase of the Bach. End on the next phrase. You're gonna do great tonight. Nervous?
No.
Really? You're not nervous? I'm kidding. Is your family coming tonight?
It's just me and my mom, and no, she's not coming.
Why?
She's busy.
My family was hard on me. My parents were both pianists. So every day after school.
I'm sorry?
You're gonna do great tonight.
Can we practice the prelude again?
Sure, from the opening? No,
the coda.
If you turn it up to 144.
Take that with your right hand. The fingering is all wrong. Taught you better than this.
Again. When you play, don't stop. When you play, focus on what drives you. What makes this worth it? What forces you to play? Don't slow down. For me, it was my mother. Rebound. She didn't believe in what I could do. She kept pushing and pushing, and the pain from the ruler.
What?
What's wrong? If you're looking for a critique, you could speed up. Here, let's go to 152.
Well? You weren't invited. I don't want you here.
Oh, but I'm your mother. I want to listen too.
How exciting. So many people in the audience. Do you think they'll applaud? It's piano, not forte. You're embarrassing me.
You're running out of time.
Sloppy, sloppy, sloppy.
Too much pedal!
Wash off, wash on, wash off, wash on, wash off. Such a disappointment.
Are you ready to play?
La 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 la. They're kicking us out of the universe, they're kicking us out of the show. Right on, right on, we'll soon be gone, as over the hill we go. As over the hill we go, as over the hill we go. Right on, right on, we'll soon be gone, as over the hill we go. La 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 la. La 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 la.
I can't get anything done. It's finals week. I have shit I need to do. No, it's this fucking medication. It wasn't like this before. Well, you're not the one taking it, so. Yeah, you're right. I'm overreacting.
Hello. It's me, Catherine, Mr. Lovey. It's so good to see your transition's begun. Go into the woods, Catherine. You've been cooped up in this room for too long.
Thank you. this is love. Mm-hmm. So this is love. So this is what makes life divine. I'm all aglow.
Now I know
the key to all heaven is mine. My heart has wings and I can fly. I'll touch every star in the sky. So this is the
Daniela.
Hello.
Say hola.
Hola.
How are you?
Okay.
Look at me. Look at the camera. Big smiles. Say adieu.
Adieu.
But look at the camera. Leave the shampoo alone. Let me have
it. Hey, long amigo. Ya han pasado 6 meses desde que nos fuimos la última vez. Me pregunto cuándo será la próxima. ¿Será pronto? ¿O crees que pasarán otros 6 meses hasta que se realice nuestro reencuentro?
Abbott Park. Trails that lead to larger roads and unfamiliar faces. A continuation of existence. Nature refined, as ordinary as all that meets the eye. A collision between the grazed and the untouched. A transtemporal reaction uniting the ever-changing leaves and the ever-growing self.
I miss you, Danny. I miss you a lot. I can't wait to see you soon. I love you.
Interconnected with the hands that built these bridges stone by stone 180 years ago, I now traverse, tranquila, as thoughts like snowflakes dance their way to becoming something larger than a prospect, larger than my ego. In this accustomed reality, I am words ignited by the beauty of truth until scolded into the memory of a little girl, frolic, stepping stones in a familiar stream of memories thousands of miles away.
I know we just talked on the phone, but thought maybe you might want to hear it in a message that we love you and we miss you.
All emerging root, a half open window reflecting the same mellow sunlight embodied across mountains. Within the harmonious essence of mankind and the chipmunks tiptoeing between birch trees, I become air, I become leaves, I become ground, I become water endlessly flowing until it reaches purpose. Y así estoy de vuelta en casa.
Oh, here you are. Hey.
Hola.
I got you. Say hola. Hola, Ampi. Say it.
Hola, Ampi.
Mm-hmm.
All right, gentlemen. We have a week and a half to figure out a fourth video project, and it has to be about portals. Now, the ideas we currently do have are not exactly ideal for our current budgetary and time constraints. So instead, we're gonna have to sit down meeting, we're gonna throw stuff at the wall, and see if anything sticks. So, what have we got? A shrug isn't an idea, guys.
Well, how about a doorway? Doorways are portals.
It's dark out. But I'm wearing a different jacket.
Nah, too big. Works, but we just don't have the time to figure out the art part of it.
I got it. Elevators.
And?
Well, it's going from one floor to another. That's definitely a portal.
It's even more vague than the goddamn door idea.
Oh, time travel.
No, the budget for that would be way too high.
How about a car?
I don't have a car.
Oh, you're right. Aliens.
Still don't have the budget for that.
Stairs? How the hell are stairs portals? Well, it's going from high ground to low.
That's the same idea as the elevator one.
Ground elevation, not floors.
Oh, blow me.
No, you blow me. Your ideas have also sucked.
Oh yeah, your ideas have been a real home run, Mr. fucking Einstein.
Honestly, your ideas have been so bad, you couldn't
even
write a children's novel.
What the fuck are you talking about? You've been nothing but playing video games in your room all day.
For God's sake,
meanwhile, all of us are struggling to make sure we get this goddamn project done.
Guys,
nothing. Thinking about this too expensively. We just need something that qualifies as a portal, doesn't need to be explained artistically, and can be done through the cheapest and easiest means possible.
What the fuck? My name is Gavyn. Gavyn Moreshead. Moreshead. SH compound sound. So I guess originally from Farmington, but I would say more Dover Foxcroft just because I spent most of my childhood there and that's what I associate with the words home. My mom just kind of came here on a whim because she moved from like Kentucky up to Maine when she was like 10 years old. So I wasn't here for like a lot of my childhood, but I do have like fond memories of this place. Like I remember when I was a kid, I was like on a bike or whatever and like it was raining and I slid off and just like grated half my face on the asphalt, so part of me is still there somewhere. I haven't gone to Java Joe's yet. That's where I grew up. I feel like there's still that connection to that little place. My mom worked there right after college. My mom and my dad had split up, so she was a single mother, so she didn't really have anywhere for me to go. So I would just hang out in Java Joe's in the little corner next to all the coffee grinders and stuff, and that where that little table is. But I would always sit there. I'd go out in the back, help my mom make the cream cheese and all the bagels and shit. It was actually really fun. So I have fond memories of that place. They used to have a lot of public art around here in there that they would buy, and they were very supportive of the community members. It was a little different. Farmington is more, I guess college is more just a return to this place. From a very young age, that's what I think I was like two or something, I'd just be like, Spider-Man! You know, keep friggin' playing that. So, or rewatching Sam Raimi's Spider-Man 1 over and over and over and over again until the VHS tape started unwinding and it wouldn't work anymore. So we had to buy a second one. That character does have like a strong place in the grounding of my own character. What, you know, wanted me to become like a comic book penciler or an artist or whatever you want to call it. Initially, when I came to college, like that was the idea, was I want to be a comic book artist. I didn't really have anything else to go off of besides that. That was initially the plan, but you know, you get older, you realize certain things about the world, and it's a digital age. Not a lot of people are reading comics. The initial idea was to do that, but since that's no longer really an option, I'm trying to figure out what I might be interested in, because I do like computers, I do like soldering and doing stuff like that. So stuff that's like a little bit more, not creative, but technical. Personally, like mod a lot of my games and create mods. I've done a couple of things for like Skyrim and stuff like that. There might be a chance for me to go into that kind of thing. It really depends on if I'm working with a team that I enjoy and can properly work with. I want to use my code in combination with these other people to create something special, which is more my method of approaching something. Because every time I try to create something, I want to create something that might leave an impact on somebody. Because that's what comic books did to me as a kid, like teaching me how to, all these lessons and stuff like that. Especially like Spider-Man with the whole message of like, with great power comes great responsibility and how to make good out of death and stuff like that. Because I lost my father when I was younger. And so like, as a kid, I used Peter Parker as kind of like I can do good even though I feel like shit.
You know, I've grown up in Maine, and I've seen it change a lot. It's just a very important part to Maine, so I feel like it should just be kept the same. Small Falls in Madrid. It was just a family spot, you know, that we used to go to when my brother and I were kids. It was just always a great time. It was beautiful, and yeah.
This is the parking lot of Small Falls, a short jaunt leading towards the falls itself. A slice of the Maine wilderness, right off of Route 4 going towards Rangeley. A popular destination in the summer, where people circumvent the chain link fences in order to jump into the awaiting water below. Obviously, I can't do that now. I would 100% shatter my legs and freeze, which would be bad. That being said, this is some people's idea of wilderness. It's neither right nor wrong, as definition can be shaky. It's up to you to think if it's wild or not. Farmington. A stronghold on the edge of civilization. Okay, I'm being a little facetious. Farmington is a nice town nestled in Franklin County, Maine. Many people come here as a means of connecting with wilderness. It's why I came and got stuck, I mean enrolled in college here.
Wilderness means, like, going out into the woods. There's just, like, trees and rocks and stuff like that.
Would you say that, like, Flint Woods is considered wilderness?
I don't know.
Ah, yes. Flint Woods, a well-known and historic part of Farmington. Full of hiking trails, wonderful views of the distant mountains, a cell tower, old stone fences, and tons of power lines. While Flint Woods may appear to be old, it is anything but. Flint Woods used to actually be grazing land for sheep, hence the stone fences. Now it is home to a thriving logging industry, which can be prevalent as you walk through the forest itself. You can be entranced by the fallen foliage, the timber, and the marked trees, which are painted or wrapped with plastic.
This documentary is brought to you by Bush Beer. Come into the woods and leave it on a stick in the woods. Did I say woods already? It's a bush, but it's bigger. It's a tree.
Okay, so gonna get a little bit serious here, despite the comedic kind of nature I've made about this film. So, when it comes down to it, even the presence of trails running through where I am right now, Flint Woods, and other places that I've explored, denote that it's not a wild place. And that's not to say there aren't wild places. There are so many things impacting our environment today and for a while now. And it's up to us to fix these problems, despite probably not having made them, depending on how old you are or however you are, depending, whatever. So we have to put our best foot forward and keep our heads up and make sure that we do all we can to protect this natural wilderness. So even if it's not considered wilderness per se, natural. And let me be clear, I love nature. I come here all the time. It's important to me, both spiritually and physically, to be here, to have access to the wilderness. And as hard as it is to kind of reconcile that wilderness doesn't truly exist with the impact of man, we can still help with the natural world and everything that we can view in it. And I think it's important that we keep that in mind. And remember, kids, stay safe and don't do drugs.